Hello everyone, today I am Rachna Singh, a science teacher from Takshila Model School and will be continuing class 6 topic, that is sorting of materials into groups. Okay, this is our chapter 4 and we have started it earlier. Now we are going to continue of the topic, that is properties of matter. Right, before starting this topic I want to ask one question, that is why we use utensils for cooking? Why can't we use paper? This is a utensil, suppose. Why we are using that utensil in place of paper sheet? Can we use paper also for cooking purpose? Why and why not? Yes, we are not going to use utensils. We are going to use or not going to use? We are going to use utensils only and will not use paper. Why? Because these utensils are able to warm up themselves and they are able to heat. Okay, these utensils are able to heat their surfaces as well as they are able to heat the material that is kept inside them. Okay. So, this is the reason why utensils are used for cooking purpose. While in case of paper, what will happen if I am going to make a box by the help of paper and I am going to make any of the dish in this paper, what is going to be happen? It will start burning. It will catch fire. Okay. So, I am not able to use this paper for the purpose of cooking. Right. So, for cooking purpose, we are going to use utensil. Why? Because of the property of utensil that it is able to take up the heat, acquire the heat and pass it on to the substance that is kept inside the vessel. Okay, this is the property of utensils. That's why we are using it for the purpose of cooking. Okay, next thing is that I want to ask one more question, that is why we are going to keep water inside a vessel and not in cotton clothes. We can use cotton cloth also. Cotton cloth. Are we able to use this cotton cloth for the storing purpose, for the storing of water, or we have to use a beaker or any of the utensil? Yes, students, this is very well known that you are able to keep water inside the beaker only and not in cotton cloth. Why? Because all the water will come out from that cloth. That cloth do not have the property to retain that water inside that. Right? And while in case of beaker, it has the ability to contain water inside that. Okay, उसके जो particles होते हैं, क्योंकि जो beaker है basically, उसके atoms हैं, they are combinedly packed, tightly packed with each other. Okay, so water can be contained in this. It will not come out of the beaker. Therefore, it's all about the properties of material. It's all about the properties of material that we are using for what purpose. Right? So, because of these properties of these materials, like utensil, we are using it for the purpose of cooking. This beaker, we are using it for the purpose of containing any of the liquid. Right? It is just possible because of their properties. Right? Now, students, we are going to continue the properties of matter. And the first one will be appearance. First is appearance. Students, when we look at different objects or materials, how do they look? Do they look similar? No, they do not look similar. For example, just look at this wood. Jo log hota hai, wood, tree ka jo trunk hota hai. Okay? Look at that and look over the surface of gold. Okay, what do you see in that? What is the difference in between that? It represents that it is somewhat rough. Okay, while this, the surface of gold is shiny in comparison. So the materials appear different. Okay, different materials looks as different. Like this gold, its surface is very shiny. So this property is known as luster. This property of shine, this property shiny, जिसकी वजह से ये gold shiny नजर आ रहा है, this property is known as luster. Okay, and this property is present in all the metals. जितने भी metals होते हैं उन वो सारे के सारे luster होते हैं. Means their surface is shiny. Okay, glassy होता है उनका surface. While all the non-metals are non-lustrous, they do not appear shiny, right? So next, second property is texture. Students, in this, when you are going to touch any of the object, right? When you are going to touch any of the object, when you feel that it is very smooth to touch, then its surface, then its texture is smooth. Okay, while when you are going to feel somewhat ridges is there, like this, ups and downs, grooves and ridges are there, then you will say its texture, the material, any material's texture is rough, right? For this, you can take an example that there is petal. When you are going to touch the petal of a flower, it will feel very smoothy. Okay, so its surface is smooth, right? While you are going to touch the sandpaper, its surface is rough, too much rough, right? Okay, so this is all about the texture, and the next one will be hardness. Next property is hardness. Students, the name, by the name it is very much clear that any of the substance that is hard means tough hai, strong hai. Okay, to hardness ke bare mein kaise pata chalaye? Many of the material get compressed with get compressed when we are going to press them, while many materials are like that, they are not able to compress even in spite of too much of force. तो ऐसे जो materials होते हैं जो compress नहीं होते, दबते नहीं है, compress नहीं होते force लगाने के बाद भी, they are hard substances. Okay, while the substances which get compressed by applying force, that substance are soft in nature. Okay, and that softness can be a teddy that is made up of cotton. When you are going to compress it, it will compress, right? While in case of iron, when you are going to compress the iron, it will not compress. Wo compress nahi hoga, press nahi hoga. That's why that iron is strong, or you can say it is hard. Its property is hard, right? So students, by scratching also you will be able to know whether the substance is hard or soft. When you take a crayon color and going to scratch it with nail, okay, then crayon will be scratched away. Jo crayon color hai wo remove ho jayega, dheere dheere scratch ho jayega, right? Iron scratch ho gayi, iron jo nail hoti hai wo scratch hogi? No, iron nail will not be scratched, while crayon will get scratched away, right? So in this case, crayon is soft in comparison to iron nail. Okay, one more example I am going to give it to you students here. Look at this chalk, and I have taken here iron scale. So I am just look at it is properly smoothy. Okay, and I am going to scratch it like this. So some powdery substance is coming out from this chalk. Look at this in my and in my hands also. Okay, so which one will be harder and which one is soft? This chalk powder is coming out from this chalk. So this chalk piece is softer in comparison to this iron nail, iron scale. Okay, this iron scale is comparatively harder than this chalk. Okay, the substance which gets scratched, that is softer one. Is it clear? Okay. Students, now the fourth property of matter will be transparency. Students, in this, if there is any material, okay, and it allows light to pass through it completely. This air, there is any material, and if I am going to let the light fall on this material, and it will allow all the light to pass through it. Okay, in that case, this object, this material is known as transparent. This material is known as transparent. Okay, and students, when light will pass, it means that we will be able to look the things which are kept here. Suppose this is material, this is transparent sheet. Okay, and I have kept here some substance, a vase I have kept it here. Okay, so when here in between there is transparent object, you will be able to look this object from this side. ओके सो जब लाइट पास होती है किसी ऑब्जेक्ट में से, अगर ट्रांसपेरेंट ऑब्जेक्ट हमारे बीच में है, सपोज दिस एयर इज प्रेजेंट इन बिटवीन अस एंड यू आर एबल टू लुक एट माय फेस. व्हाई? बिकॉज इन बिटवीन देयर इज एयर, और एयर की प्रॉपर्टी होती है दैट इट इज ट्रांसपेरेंट, इट अलाउज लाइट टू पास थ्रू देम. ओके, और जहां लाइट जाती है, जो भी वे है, जहां पर भी लाइट फॉल होगी, जहां पर भी लाइट पहुंच जाती है, वेर एवर इट रीचेस, वी कैन लुक एट दैट ऑब्जेक्ट बेसिकली. राइट, ये उसका प्रॉपर्टी है दैट वेर एवर लाइट फॉल, सपोज यहां लाइट फॉल हो रही है, सो वी आर एबल टू लुक एट दिस सब्सटेंस व्हाट एवर इट इज. ओके, और दिस ऑब्जेक्ट इज द ऑब्जेक्ट दैट अलाउज लाइट टू पास थ्रू इट, दैट ऑब्जेक्ट इज नोन एज ट्रांसपेरेंट object. That object is known as transparent object, and these objects can be air, glass, transparent sheet, जो polythene होती है, cover आप wrap करते हो अपने notebooks, books को. Okay, that is also transparent in nature. Right? You can look at this glass also. Look at this. You are able to look throughout this glass, clearly visible हो रहा है. Okay, so this glass is transparent. Okay, now next is translucent. Sorry, एक काम करते हैं, पहले दूसरा ऑब्जेक्ट करेंगे हम. Those substances that will allow light to pass through them, they are known as transparent, and those objects which do not allow to pass light through them. Suppose ये object है और यहां से तो light pass हो रही थी, okay? But यहां से light pass नहीं हो रही है, okay? So this type of object is known as opaque. This is known as opaque object. Students, ये board है, this is board. Are you able to look behind this board? What is behind this board? You are not able to look what is present just behind the board. Why is it so? Because this board is not allowing light to pass through it. Light iske piche nahi ja pa rahi hai, is board ko cross karke nahi ja rahi hai. That's why you are not able to look behind this board. So this board is opaque. Okay, this board is opaque object. क्लियर है स्टूडेंट्स? इसी तरीके से एक ऑब्जेक्ट और लेते हैं, सपोज दिस डायरी, दिस बुक, लाइट इज नॉट पास थ्रू इट, कोई भी लाइट पास नहीं हो रही है, यू आर नॉट एबल टू लुक एट दिस सब्सटेंस. पहले आपको नजर आ रहा था जो भी बोर्ड पे मेंशन था, बट बिकॉज ऑफ दिस बुक यू आर नॉट एबल टू लुक व्हाट इज रिटन ओवर देयर इन दिस एरिया पर्टिकुलरली. व्हाई इज इट सो? बिकॉज लाइट इज नॉट पास थ्रू इट. ओके, सो दिस टाइप ऑफ सब्सटेंस इज नोन एज ओपेक सब्सटेंसेस. क्लियर? सो नेक्स्ट, देयर आर थर्ड टाइप ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट्स ऑल्सो दैट अलाउज लाइट टू पास थ्रू देम पार्शियली. मीन्स थोड़ी थोड़ी लाइट पास होती है. द ऑब्जेक्ट्स विच अलाउज लाइट टू पास थ्रू देम पार्शियली. ओके, दीज टाइप ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस आर नोन एज ट्रांसल्यूसेंट. ओके, दीज टाइप ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस आर नोन एज ट्रांसल्यूसेंट सब्सटेंसेस. एंड एग्जाम्पल यू कैन टेक बटर पेपर ऑल्सो. Okay, or the paper on which there is oil. Okay, so you are able to just look at that partially. थोड़ा थोड़ा नजर में आता है आपको. Okay, look here. I am going to look at. Suppose this is paper and I have put some oil on this, so that it has become translucent. Means some of the light will pass through it. Students, अभी आपको ये transparency word exactly clear है. Why? Because in between the substance, the object is air. Air present here. Air is transparent. Okay, that's why these words are very much clear to you. But when I'm going to keep this paper, यहां से देखो clear है, कुछ भी दिख रहा है आपको? नहीं दिख रहा. Okay, now I'm going to put light on this. Look here, students, from this. जहां पे ये ऑयल है बेटा, यहाँ पे आपको वर्ड नजर आ रहा है. लुक एट दिस, ध्यान से देखो, टी नजर आ रहा है. आ रहे नजर? टी आर ए एन एस पी ए आर ई एन सी वाई. इज इट क्लियर? सो व्हेन लाइट विल पास थ्रू द पेपर, दिस इज ट्रांसलूसेंट पेपर, we will be able to look the things partially. हमें थोड़ा थोड़ा नजर आएगा, जैसे कि अभी हमें ये word बिल्कुल clear नजर आ रहा है, but हम जैसे ही हमने translucent object लिया तो हमें ये partially नजर आ रहा था, थोड़ा थोड़ा नजर आ रहा था. It was not very much clear for us to see this object. Is it clear? Students, one more example I have taken it for you. Look at this bottle. From the above portion, it is very much clear to see. Look, मेरा हैंड बिल्कुल अच्छे से क्लियर हो रहा है, यहां से देख रहे हो सर. But when you are looking from this, actually it is a sanitizer, so it surface, look at this, it is somewhat translucent. Okay, तो आप यहां से देखो, मेरा हैंड पीछे बैक में, it is not very much clear. बिल्कुल भी अच्छे से क्लियर नहीं है, but it is somewhat clear. Look at this. बट फ्रॉम द अबव पोर्शन इट इज वेरी मच क्लियर. सो ये जो पोर्शन है बॉटल का, दिस इज ट्रांसपेरेंट एंड दिस लिक्विड इज ट्रांसल्यूसेंट. सो आई होप द थिंग्स आर वेरी मच क्लियर टू यू. ऑल दीज थिंग्स, ट्रांसपेरेंट ऑब्जेक्ट, ट्रांसल्यूसेंट एंड ऑपेक ऑब्जेक्ट आर वेरी मच क्लियर टू यू. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, थैंक यू.